We're on the clock in Missouri, next on the Journal.
From every point on the compass, from the woodlands and fields and waterways, come thrills and excitement and challenges enough for every man, woman, and child. These are our adventures, our stories of the wild places, both near and far. All of the hits, the misses, the memories. Our time spent living the wild life. Join us. Venture out into the world at the end of the asphalt. The world of the Wilderness Journal. The Journal is underwritten by
Algoma Country, Ontario, Canada. It's that scenic, that remote, that calm. 100-page travel guide available at fishalgoma.net. And by Heinz Propane, with locations in Mount Pleasant, Clare, Beaverton, and Harrison, Michigan. Heinz Propane provides residential and commercial services throughout the state. Heinz Propane, your hometown propane provider. And by the Ina Store in Tustin, Michigan. Ina Store features Case, IH, and a full line of Kubota tractors and RTVs, as well as parts, service, and accessories. The Ina Store in beautiful downtown Ina, Michigan. By Mads Outdoor Product, a full-line Avalon dealer. Mads also features MiroCraft boat and Featherlight trailer, as well as combination boat, dock, and lift packages. Mads Outdoor Product, in the center of it all, Harrison and Cadillac, Michigan. Captioning provided by DP Tire Services Commercial and Retread Division.
Hi, friends, and welcome. As you can tell, a little bit of snow has fallen here on our bend in the river. It's a brisk 13 degrees this morning as I stand here, and that's not terribly bad, except for the fact that it's the 10th of November. Yeah, just a little chilly still. That's no indication of just how hot the action is in today's adventure. We're going to head south and west today down to Missouri, where we're going to try to hang a tag on one of the Northeast Missouri big old bucks that everybody talks about. And by we, I should tell you, grandson camera guy Kyle Jr. and I are going to run down, and we're going to go hunt with Dave and Ryan, everybody down at Northeast Missouri Outfitters. If you're a frequent flyer, you may recall we hunted there last year in their late hunt, and they very graciously invited us to come back. So fast forward 11 months, and we're going down for the first week of November with 5 days to try to hang that tag. Now, I will tell you, as I drove down there, I was thinking that 5 days is a pretty standard length for a hunt, but with all the moisture, all the rain we've had this fall, I was really wondering, would that be enough time? Hey, I'm your host, Kyle Randall. This is my Wilderness Journal, and when Ryan Lewis said you ought to see the rut down here on our property down in Missouri, this part of the country, the deer just run like crazy, I, of course, said, show me.
The afternoon we got to camp, it was so windy the squirrels were having trouble staying in the trees, but it didn't matter.
You ready? Yep. All right. We'll see.
We got in the stand. And we hadn't been in that stand 10 minutes when we saw our first deer. A doe fawn walked out of the creek bottom, followed shortly by what I presume was its mother, and together they worked right up along in front of us. I was thinking, man, it's a good thing we're already in the stand. The deer are moving even in this wind this early. And what was even better is they crossed right through the scrape right under the fence where the guys said they would. And all I needed was for Mr. Big to be following. Unfortunately, he wasn't following. He was, in fact, up along the far edge of the field waiting. And when that doe and fawn walked out, he came charging right out at him. This looked to be a pretty nice 8-point, probably a 3-year-old, a good-looking deer. Exactly the kind of buck you hope to see on your first day in a stand. I watched this buck for a little bit, pushed that doe and fawn around, and I decided he wasn't quite what we were looking for. Still, this was a dandy, mature buck out and about before dark on our first day.
By 3 p.m. that first afternoon, we'd already seen a pretty nice 8-point despite some moderately high winds. In fact, Junior asked me if I thought the tree we were in might break in all this wind, and if it did, what should he do? Well, I assured him that big old oak is probably going to be just fine, and besides, we'd already seen a nice buck, and we hadn't been there an hour yet.
By 3 o'clock, we were seeing legs and then entire bodies of deer working their way out of the CRP ground and out into the field. There were several does and fawns just working their way along, feeding in the hay field. But every few minutes, one or more of them would throw their head up and stare off in another direction. I was fairly certain that with this many girls, sooner or later, yeah, a boy was going to find his way to the dance. I kept looking for a buck, but so far the only thing I noticed was one old doe with a single fawn was slowly working herself back into our area. Now, friends, if you haven't hunted the rut much, believe me when I tell you the single best thing you can have out in front of your stand is a doe. And fortunately for us, this one seemed bent on coming right back to us right up underneath our tree. The doe and fawn stopped for a drink out of the creek just below our stand and then walked right up the path right past us. And remember what I said about having a doe under or in front of your tree? Well, it oftentimes does attract a buck. This time, not necessarily the buck we were hoping for, but you get my point. Trust me, friends, absolutely nothing works better than the real thing.
45 minutes later, a doe, fawn, and that young buck crossed the creek and came right up underneath our stand. Now, it'd be a couple of years before that little guy was a shooter, but I point that out because they were directly downwind again, and if even one of those deer smells or sees us, it's game over before we ever get started. If they get to snorting and stomping around, there is absolutely no way a mature deer is going to come out anywhere close to us. And speaking of mature deer,
with the wind still rocking our tree, it wasn't long after 3 o'clock when I looked over and there was a dandy 8 just standing there on the fence line between the CRP and the grass field.
It's close. It's a nicer 8.3.
The way our tree was moving around, it was kind of hard to watch him through the binoculars, but I figured him to be a 3-year-old, He had decent mass. He wasn't real tall, just about ear wide, just a nice, respectable 8 point. And as I sat there watching him eating acorns, it occurred to me, what are you gonna do if that buck walks over here? Are you gonna take a run at him? Is that the deer you came to Missouri for? And as I sat there contemplating that possibility, I heard a little crunch of leaves behind me. Here was a little buck, I think the same little buck that followed the doe and fawn past us, only now he was working his way back, and when he got out into the grass field, he stopped and he stared at that 8 point, and then he laid his ears back and started marching right over there like he was going to kick his butt. Talk about punching above your weight class. I thought for sure that little guy was going to get stomped. But he didn't. He walked over there, the big buck came in, kind of circled him a little, and then basically ignored him. I was fairly certain that older buck was thinking the same thing I was thinking. Yeah, there was something wrong with that younger buck's head. That's the first time I've ever seen a buck that small walk up and posture like that and not get run over.
That's not that 8 point them guys were talking about. It's a nice buck, but he's still just not quite big enough.
And when the little tough guy walked off in one direction, the 8 point walked off in the other, so I never really did have to choose.
That was a really nice 8, and his left brow tine with that crook in it told me it wasn't the buck we'd seen in the field earlier. He was a little bigger, and I have to tell you, at one point he was close enough I probably could have taken a run at him. Yes, I did pass, but it also did occur to me just after I did, you know, that's the third buck we've seen from this stand in less than 3 hours, and it was just the first day.
Just after 4, I saw something come up out of the creek bottom, only this wasn't no deer.
Some bobcat.
This was a pretty good-sized bobcat. He was just walking away, so I tried grunting at him a couple times, see could I turn him to look back. And when I did, a buck walked out from the same creek bank in the same place, just like he was following that cat, only he turned and started looking for whatever it was he heard grunting. This 2-year-old 8 point with a broken brow tine was standing right there, right in front of us. He was a good-looking deer. In a year or two, he'd be a real dandy. But for now, well, for now, he was just entertainment. And just as he started to walk back in, the way he'd come out, something happened that, well, let's just say it surprised even an old guy.
If a tree falls in the forest, it definitely makes a noise. That great big limb just fell off and scared that buck. It just fell. I guess they all kind of fall sometimes. Ryan might have a head out on me, I don't know. That's pretty cool.
That very large branch broke and fell right into the path that the guys had cleared to our stand. Yeah, I guess it's true what they say, timing really is everything. And I also think that after seeing a bobcat and that buck with the busted off brow tine, I couldn't believe just how much action we'd seen on that first afternoon. That buck obviously spooked when that branch fell, but it wasn't long before.
After making a circle, that very same buck came out behind us and then came right back to us. He was still looking for the buck he heard or the girl he thought he should have, or I don't know what he was looking for, but he came right back in. Judging by the busted off brow tine and the lump still on his head between his eyes, I figured this young fellow was looking more for a fight than love. But the bottom line, it was good to be seeing deer, and we were seeing lots of them.
As I watched him trot off, I couldn't help but think, there goes a really nice 2-year-old. And I also couldn't help but think, even though the sun is setting on our first day, this place has definitely lived up to the guy's advanced billing.
It was just before 6, and we'd seen a lot of action, so I wasn't surprised when a doe and fawn come working out. Then I heard Kyle whisper, "Buck." I looked up just in time to see a body disappearing across the CRP.
That's a buck.
I looked through the binos and I thought I saw antler. I decided to do a little doe bleat just to see.
That's a good buck.
And it worked. He was coming. And as he got closer, I could actually hear him softly grunting with each step. He stopped for a second and then started walking again. All he had to do now was stay on that path, and he was going to step right out in my shooting lane. And he would have, too, except when Kyle leaned out to keep the camera on him, his stand creaked, and there he stood, looking, trying to find the noise. Nothing between us but a couple of oak leaves. And then, like an old buck will do, he decided something's not right. He turned and cautiously started back the way he'd come. I decided to try a little voice grunt at him, see could I stop him. He was getting out there, but... And he actually did stop for just a second. And then he took a couple steps and he stopped again. Ever so slowly, I twisted myself around that tree and...
Tipped over. He rolled right there. He rolled.
Yeah. I had him the whole time.
How's that for getting it done first night?
He's right there, buddy. Right here. One night super buck. How about this Northeast Missouri Outfitters? Holy smokes. Dave and Ryan. These guys said we'd have a tremendous, can you believe it? How many bucks we see? This is crazy. And that's a big old 10 point. I'm sure that's one of them bucks they showed me the pictures of. Oh yeah, he's all done. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. And thank you, Junior. You the man. What do you think of this?
It's pretty cool. A little exciting.
A little exciting?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, you don't have to, he's not gonna hear us. He's not laying over there taking a nap. Oh man. Can you imagine an old man like me getting this excited over it? That's awesome, man. Come out here and to get this done in one night and to see the action that we have seen.
It is pretty exciting.
Yeah, it's incredible. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. I can't believe it. He lays right there, man. There's no tracking, no nothing.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And thank you.
You're welcome.
That was so cool, so exciting. I could hear you. You were breathing harder than I was. Between the two of us, I was sure he was going to hear that.
Yeah, probably.
I'll tell you what, man. That was awesome. Thanks again.
You're welcome.
Boy, when your stand creaked and he stopped right there,
yeah,
I thought it's game over.
I thought it was done as well.
And he just, boom, hit the brakes because he was coming right to that crossing where the guy said they would. And he turned and he circled back and he was looking for that noise. And fortunately, straight downwind of us, 32 yards, straight downwind, that's what that odor control does for you. He gave us a second chance and a great buck. If you don't take care of your scent, that buck never goes past there the first time, let alone comes back on high alert.
No, it doesn't.
Awesome. Thanks again.
You're welcome.
You ready to get out and go see a big buck?
Yep.
I am too. Let's go get her done. Ryan, Dave, guys, thank you. This is absolute. This is everything you said it'd be and more. And we've only been hunting like 4 hours. It don't get a whole lot better than this. Thank you, guys. Thank you, everybody up at Northeast Missouri Outfitters. This is absolutely awesome.
Friends, we had a great buck down within sight of our stand, and we'd only been hunting for 4 hours.
Why don't we go over here now that we've caught our breath and look for my arrow? I'm sure it's a through and through. All right, you want to do that?
Sure.
Come here somewhere. Oh, it's right here. See that? Right there. Yeah, we're not going to have to any track there. We know where the deer's at. Mm-hmm. It's obvious that we definitely double lunged them. And you know what? I got my phone. Let's walk out to the top of the hill. Give Dave and Ryan a call. Everybody likes it. I mean, we don't have to do no track and we know where this deer is. But you know what? Everybody likes to go on the recovery. Let's just slow our roll, give them a shout. They ought to be about done. It's getting dark, and see if they want to come and join us. Besides that, need somebody to pick that big deer up. You don't want to carry it, do you?
No.
I don't want to carry it. I hurt my back again. Let's just go back over to our stuff and give them a shout. What do you say?
Okay.
This one's gonna be hard to find, but what do you think? They gonna be all right?
He's a little better than you think he is.
Oh, he's
close to 140.
I told you, one high 130 is real low 140. I think that's right in the wheelhouse, don't you think?
You ain't getting no perfect than that.
Nope, he had everything I required. What do you think? Get down there behind that thing, turn him around. What's your name?
Kyle.
Nice deer.
Thanks.
Kyle. Right. Hey, can I ask you to tell me, how do you feel right now?
Pretty excited.
Can I ask you one more thing?
Sure.
Can I borrow your deer for a minute?
Yes, you can.
It's a couple of days after Halloween, and I am really, really glad we waited to go trick-or-treating. This thing is beautiful. Solid, symmetrical. I never want to guess the number, but it's a good number, 10 point. And it is everything you hope to see when you come down here. And Dave and Ryan and everybody down here, every single person down here works so hard all year long. And that's the secret. They work all year to get guys and gals down here on a deer like that. And obviously, even an old man like me and a young kid can come down here and get it done. We have been here totally in camp for 6 hours, been hunting for 4 hours. We saw four great 8 points, including one that, quite frankly, was in real jeopardy. A really nice buck. I thank you guys so much, every one of you. Thank you. And thank you, Kyle. Thank the Lord. I tell you, he's been good to me. One more time. I can't believe it. It's absolutely awesome.
Yeah, he is. This is how I blow up my back. Last man. Nice job, thank you, Ben.
What a tremendous hunt. And no, it doesn't always go like that. But that is exactly what did happen on a Show Me State hunt with Northeast Missouri Outfitters. And we truly want to thank Dave and Ryan, everybody down there that worked so hard all year long to make that such a great hunt. And I truly want to thank grandson cameraman Kyle Jr. for going along with his grandpa, making another memory or two before time steals away these chances. It's not lost to me that tick, tick, tick is getting louder right behind me. Hey, I hope we see some of you down there. I hope you're looking at a Show Me State buck of your own. And if you have a little luck like we did and we bump into you, we'll help you drag yours out. And then I promise we're going to share some deer stories and a cup and a fire. And friends, if I don't see you down there, well, then I'll certainly be waiting for you right back here so we can share another adventure from my wilderness journal.